Barrett's esophagus, I usually describe as cells in the esophagus after chronic acid reflux start to change and turn into precancerous cells. The population that's most affected by Barrett's esophagus are white Caucasian male over the age of 50. The hard part about screening for Barrett's esophagus is that most patients with Barrett's esophagus have no symptoms. The only small sign that we get are patients who have had heartburn for a long time. In general, we do recommend patients who have had heartburn for 5 to 10 years definitely discuss it with their primary care physicians. Unfortunately, some patients have heartburn and actually don't feel it. A lot of times, by the time symptoms develop, such as difficulty swallowing or food getting stuck, that's usually a little late. At that time, usually a tumor has developed. So when Barrett's esophagus is suspected, the first thing we do is to review the biopsy results as well as the endoscopy results to confirm that Barrett's esophagus is present. Not infrequently, someone could be thought to have Barrett's esophagus, but actually may just have inflammation of the esophagus. Once Barrett's esophagus is confirmed, we look for something called dysplasia. Dysplasia means precancerous changes. When dysplasia is found, we can actually get rid of that by a minimally invasive method called radiofrequency ablation, and more recently, cryoablation. It's just fancy words saying using heat or using liquid nitrogen to freeze those bad tissues and allow the esophagus new healthy cells to form. Once Barrett's esophagus with dysplasia is eradicated, we perform a test to decide whether or not medication is sufficient to control acid reflux. If not, then the patients will be referred for consideration of something called fundoplication or surgery, which is to tighten the valve between the esophagus and the stomach and prevent acid reflux from occurring and thus hopefully prevent Barrett's esophagus from reoccurring again. The best methods for preventing Barrett's esophagus is a healthy diet, high fruits and vegetable, avoiding tobacco smoking, avoiding drinking, and also treating heartburn. There are a lot of exciting things going on here at Stanford. In addition to radiofrequency and cryoablation, we also have advanced imaging technique called confocal microscopy, which actually allows us to look at the esophagus as if we're looking with a microscope to help us better pinpoint the location of the Barrett's esophagus. My immediate hopes for this field is better education and awareness, especially to the patients, not to ignore heartburn, that it really is a warning sign. Long-term goal, I hope to decrease the incidence of esophageal cancer. More recent data has shown that the incidence of esophageal cancer has tripled in the last 20 years, while a lot of the other cancers have either decreased in incidence or plateaued. We think obesity has to do with it. We think our diet has to do with it. And I hope to be part of the team that helps bring that incidence down.